I don't like the look of this thing. If you don't know what that is, this is Twitch's own sub-goal widget. So for affiliates and partners, they can set up a goal and have a little bar on screen that will fill up every time they get a new sub. Now you get access to this on your dashboard under quick actions. Boom, if you don't see it here, you can just click on the plus and go find it. So right there under grow your community, boom. But that's not my issue right there. If I click on it, this is the original look of it and I don't like it at all. Now, Twitch actually gives you a couple of options to customize it. We're gonna start a new goal. Let's click here and boom. This is where you can basically set up your goal. For example, I'm gonna set it to 5 subs, right? You can have a description for your sub goal, but I never put it. It's just new sub goal. And then under customize, you can click on customize progress bar and click here. So you have the light modes, as I like to call them. The background is gonna be white and then there's gonna be a color for the progress bar. And then the opposite, where the background's gonna be black and there's gonna be a color on top of it. I like this one. It's my favorite one. But here's the problem. I don't like the icon. I don't like the gray border. I don't like the weird rounded rectangle. So I wanted to do something about it. So I went to Twitter. And I tweet, comment with your logo or some of your channel artwork and I'll pick some to make an overlay. For some reason, I did not expect over 100 people to participate. A lot of you came in, drop your logos, drop your channel artworks, and it was cool. First one that caught my eye was Tiffany Witcher's logo. And I was like, hey, let me create something maybe extravagant with this. I actually followed Tiffany, I watched Tiffany, and I like her original artwork. So I wanted to try an easy method. That easy method would be to just, you know, grab a screenshot of the sub goal and then go into Adobe After Effects and Photoshop, create something animated that she could just slap on top of the normal sub goal. And it turned out pretty well. I put a logo on top of the Twitch default logo. You can see a little bit of the background here. I placed some waves and I created basically this overlay that just goes on top of it with no modification or anything. Of course, you can go into your effects filters and add a color correction filter, right? Play with the hue and then you can change any source in OBS Studio. But that really wasn't enough for me because I wanted to change the shape and do all sorts of cool stuff with it. That's when I found out that there's another way to customize this progress bar by using custom CSS straight inside of OBS Studio. In this design, for example, I'm using a combination of Photoshop plus custom CSS. I made the edges sharp compared to the rounded rectangle that we have here, got rid of that border, and also went with a color gradient for the progress bar. On this one, for example, I created the design in Photoshop, and then using custom CSS within OBS, I got rid of the logo, got rid of the left text, I rounded the rectangle completely, and I have a gradient for the background, and then when it fills up, it's going to look like that. Now, I'm super excited to show you basically how I found out how to modify things with the custom CSS, knowing that I don't know anything about CSS. But on top of modifying shapes and colors, you can also do animation with custom CSS. But we will get into all that after a message from our sponsor. And it turns out that our sponsor is Owned, and Owned actually gives you sub-goal widgets, so you don't have to do all the complicated stuff that I'm about to show you. If for some reason you don't know anything about Owned Pro, it is an all-in-one service that gives you everything you need in order to be a successful live streamer. You get access to a lot of overlays. I'm talking a lot. I'm talking 600 plus overlays that are each available in at least 9 languages. All the overlays are one-click install, so no stress for that. You get a Twitch chatbot to moderate your chat and also add custom commands. But this is not what we're here to talk about. They just added this new thing. If you go in your dashboard and you go to tools, you will find goal bars. So yes, that makes the rest of this video irrelevant because you can just go up there, click create goal, select what type of goal you want, subscriber goal for example, put a title, help me get a glittering unicorn, and then you can choose your style. And of course, in good old Owned fashion, you have a ton of options, like a lot. Let's go with the Arcade Pro. Just click here to select it and then enter the goal amount. Boom, let's go for 50 subs. Then you can set for the goal to end at a specific date or not. Click save and publish. From there, it's easy peasy. Copy your URL to the clipboard, go to your OBS, add it as a browser source, and boom, you have a way better looking sub goal than the original Twitch one. Keeping in mind that you can set it up for follows, you can set it up for bits and for donations. Anyways, I'll let you check it out over at own.gg/gallevelpro. That is own3d.gg/gallevelpro. Okay, so here's how to customize Twitch's sub bar from the perspective of someone who doesn't know much about CSS. So the first thing I had to do was basically start a goal. Boom, started the goal. So now it's going on. I have to go back into the quick actions and find the browser source link. So right there, if I click on the little copy icon, it will copy it to my clipboard. Now I can open up a new tab, press Control V and open it up. That's not what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to go into OBS Studio. You should know this. Click the plus on your source list and then add a browser source. But we're going to have this inside of a new tab, right? And then from there, I needed to find out what they used. for the code, the specific names of the specific parts. By the way, if for some reason you're a CSS expert watching this video, prepare to cringe. I don't think I need another warning that I don't know anything about CSS. So I went here and I pressed F12. And from there, I can manage to inspect element. I'm gonna click top left here, okay, little button, and then I can hover over specific parts. When I click here, what it will do is basically tell me about the HTML, but also the CSS under styles here, right? From there, all I had to do is deduce, be a deducer and deduce what was what. Of course, when I hover over the logo after clicking this, boom, I know that, okay, goal widget image, that's the image. And if I check here, goal widget image, that's basically the image. And that's the CSS code for that image. The only thing that it knows is that, hey, post that image, the height is gonna be 70%, max width 20%. I don't know where the rest of the code is. I don't need to know. Now, to this, I can add the line, basically copy this part and then put it back into OBS, right? So let me copy my link here. Let's go here into OBS. I'm gonna click plus, right? I'm going to go to a browser, click okay, paste the link here. And then the width and height, you actually want to go with what Twitch recommends. Twitch will tell you it's 1480 by 160. Click okay, and you should have your sub goal, boom. That's a new sub goal. It's at zero, so that's why it looks like that. And if you double click on it, bring this up, drag this down, expand it a little bit, bring this back up so we can see what we're doing. This is where you would put the custom CSS. I'm going to go ahead and delete whatever is here at default. So remember that code that we had right there? It's basically the name of the, I think it's called class. I really don't know anything. It's basically the name of that specific part of the thing. And then between the squiggly lines, you put specific commands. So if I right click and I click copy here, then I go back to OBS and I paste. Now it already knows that it has to put the height and the max width. So we don't know. We don't need that. And from there, whatever you want to do with the image, you look up. You want to flip it upside down. You go to Google, you type flip upside down CSS, and they're gonna tell you exactly what to type, basically. So for me, it was like, oh, how do I drag the opacity to zero? Or how do I make it completely disappear? Another tutorial on how to Google with get level. CSS opacity, boom. And I click on this. And it tells you the opacity properties, we don't care. Boom, opacity 0.5, all right. In between the squiggly lines, I'm gonna copy this. I'm gonna put that, but watch out, it might not work. Click okay, and the logo is still there. First of all, the CSS experts will realize that I forgot to copy the period up here. So let's go back and add the period, because this is basically not good code. This might actually work, but I still wanna show you what to do if it doesn't work. As you can see, it's semi-transparent. So if I go back here, so that works, right? There is a command called important. If ever you add a command and let's say that this didn't work, I would have had to just add exclamation mark important, and it would basically override whatever is keeping it from being affected. Now let's set this to just 0% or just zero. Let's click okay. And now the logo is completely transparent. All right, you want to change the background color? Figure out what's the background in CSS. So go here, boom, maybe hover over the whole thing, just like that. And as you can see, this is a weird name here. I don't think that's it. But you can also hover here and see what's being highlighted. And if anything looks familiar, you know, like goal underscore widget, that's probably it. So copy the dot this time. Let's go back, double click, all right. Give it a couple of enters. Boom, that's goal widget. Let's add two squiggly lines. One that opens, one that closes. And in between, what do we want? Background color. So let's go ahead and find. You don't even have to Google anymore. You can just stay here and look up all the CSS things that you can do. Probably stuff that you didn't even think of, right? Like CSS 2D transforms, 3D transforms, transitions, animations, but also basic CSS backgrounds, right? So first one is gonna be background color light blue. Let's test this one out. All right, background color light blue between the goal widget, and let's see what it does. It does nothing. Remember the important part? Or maybe did I mess up somewhere? That's the problem with code, right? So let me go here, press space, type important, because this is very important for us, right? Let's click okay. And now it's light blue. It doesn't look like anything. It looks horrible, in fact. But we successfully modified the background color. That opens the window to everything now. All right, now that you get the gist of it, let me give you a short version of everything by using this one that I made as an example. So I went in Photoshop. Basically, I made this. It has a little bit of a shine to it. I used a screenshot, if you will, of the original one just to size it up a little bit, especially for the height, because I didn't want to change the height. Of course, I went in here and basically tried to find out what was what, especially for this text here. If I go back in there and basically show you the code, you're gonna see, so no borders. The background is actually a gradient between two grays. No text on the left and also no logos on the left. In my Go widget, I use the CSS command of background linear gradient. That's how you do a gradient. And then you're gonna have the hashtag, the hex color for both colors. And then border, I set that to 0 pixels to make sure that there was no gray, weird looking border. I had to put the important part in order for it to work. And then border radius, this is basically the rounded rectangle part of it. I put it 150. For the other design that I did for Cgamer, for example, I had to put it at 0 so that I wouldn't have any rounded rectangle at all. It would be sharp. As you can see, this is basically the blank one for Cgamer. All right, let's go back. All right, Go widget progress bar. Now we can't see it because, you know, our goal is at 0 right now. All I did was add the background linear gradient just to make sure that the progress bar is going to be green when it fills up, right? And this one, as you can see, it has a different name. We have Go widget, which is basically the background, and then Go widget underscore underscore progress bar, which is the progress bar. Again, I had to put important in order for it to match. Then what we're familiar with, Go widget image, I only put the opacity at 0% and I set it to important. And this weird name, which is .GCWLMZ, that's actually the left text. I tried to move it a little bit so that the logo would show up and the text would also show up. But every time I moved it, this thing would move around and I don't like to figure things out. I do, but not in this case, not when it comes to code. So I just decided, hey, you know what? Let me put opacity 0 on that text also. You can see that here I have margin 0. That's because I was trying to margin it, but technically I can get rid of that. It doesn't matter because the opacity is 0, so it's not gonna be visible. So those are the ones that I figured out. Now, my community, the big brain people in my community, actually find out how to animate the gradients. Because as I was finding out those things with OBS and CSS, I was live tweeting them. So basically I was telling people how to hide the image. When I found out how to get rid of the border, I posted the code, warned them that I was absolute garbage at CSS, still am, showed them some mistakes that I made. If you want to mess it up completely, did not share that code, shared some troubleshooting, mistyping stuff. And of course, what I'm very proud of is the rounded rectangle. But here's where it gets spicy. This is where I found out how to do the gradients, right? So linear gradient with one or two gradients. I also knew that you could put however many colors you want in order to have a gradient in between them. Just keep it simple, two colors, you're fine. Then Dark Qualza found out how to animate them and saved me so much time from Googling stuff. So basically in the Go widget, which is the background, they added background linear gradient, right? There was a degree for the gradient here, 45 degrees, minus 45 degrees. And then there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different colors. They added a background size in order to make it big, basically so that the gradient is really spread out. And then here's the line that's important. Animation gradient, 15 seconds, ease, infinite. Infinite is probably loop. I'm deducing right now. I haven't tried it yet. We're gonna try it together, right? And 15 seconds is, hey, ease yourself into this color, into that color, into this color, into that color for 15 seconds and then repeat. And then there's add keyframes gradient, which basically tells, I guess, the animation when to start, where's the position when it starts and stuff like that. I don't know anything. I don't know. It doesn't matter. So they shared where they found the CSS code. They even showed a little example here that we're gonna take a look at. And this is what it looks like. This is, can you imagine? Like, this is an animation made 100% on OBS Studio. No plugins, nothing. Straight raw OBS. Like that. Yeah, that's what they shared. They added a little bit more colors for some reason, but yeah. All right, they referenced this website, so let's check it out. Hopefully we can just copy paste some code from there. There we go. There's diagonal color gradients and there's a bunch of pop-ups. Leave me alone website. And as you can see, this is slowly moving in. Let's click on CSS and see the actual code. So body, blah, 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 blah. So background. So this is the code that we want, right? All we're gonna do is change the word body to our actual class, which was widget goal, I think. And then we'll make sure that we didn't copy one too many squiggly lines. Is that the scientific term? Squiggly lines. It is now, okay? So let's try this with the dollar yen's progress bar. I want to keep the border radius, that's for sure. The only thing that we're really replacing here is the background linear gradient, and then we want a different one for the add keyframes that comes with it, right? So I'm just going to select this just for visual. Let me go back here and not actually select everything. Let's go and do this. Let's just select the linear gradient. Okay, boom, with the background size and the animation. Nice. So now we can add it in between our border and our border radius. Copy and control V. All right, so it should be added now. Let's check out the keyframes part. So that has to be on a different class or whatever they call them. All right, let's copy the other squiggly line. Press enter twice just so we can see actually way more. Boom, control V. There we go. And I wonder if that will work. Let's go back and check Dark Qualza's code to see what's important and what's not important. Important, no, boom. Looks like we won't need that. Okay, that's cool. And let's click okay. See what's up. And would you look at that? It works. It works. Now that's the background. You may not want the background to be animated, or at least you don't want like vibrant colors. You might want it to animate between gray and some, you know, light colors or desaturated colors so that the progress bar can really grab the attention. But, you know, ultimately you do whatever you want with it. Now, again, for the Photoshop part, I don't want to make this a Photoshop tutorial. But as I said, all I had to do is add it into my OBS and then screenshot it. Right. I screenshot the source that I added just so I can know the exact size. And then in Photoshop, if I wanted to add anything, basically what I would do is create anything around it. I just added the logo and then added some effects on top of it. Boom. Easy clap. Same thing for dollar yen. That's how it started. First thing I did was basically add this border and then added the green, then some little highlights, then some extra details, the more highlights, and then that's a shadow for the logo, and boom, that's it. That's all I did. That's the reference I had. And then I knew that I was going to round the rectangle and basically adjust it into OBS. And that's it. Now, do you need Photoshop to do that? Of course not. You can do this in MS Paint if you have to. No excuses. Now, this is one of many ways that you can customize your Twitch sub progress bar. Of course, the easy button would be to use services that already give you widgets, such as Own Pro. But the key takeaway here is that I didn't know anything about CSS and I deduced. You can also deduce. If I can do it, you can do it. And also, did I mention that I stream on Twitch? You should follow me there. You should come talk to me there. You should watch my streams. It gets pretty weird, pretty random there, so I'm pretty sure you would appreciate it. Other than that, I have a hard time saying that. Check out my Twitter thread about the progress bar, and if you have any insight, if you are that CSS expert that's gonna be typing, oh, you did this wrong, you did that wrong, go in the thread and actually give us tips, okay? I can't be the only one sharing those tips. Thank you so much for Dark Qualza for sharing the animation. Saved me a lot of time from Googling stuff. Don't keep it all to yourself, all right? Participate. And I will see you guys next time. Go out there. I'll make me proud. Okay, level out.